Thank you so much. Thank you guys for coming out. So good to see you all tonight. I'm trying to see if my friend Meryl is here. She said she might be here. But anyway, thank you for coming out. And for those of you that don't know what in the world Happyslip is, and you're probably like, what kind of a name? Like, why would anyone pick a screen name like that? It's kind of weird, right? About 11 years ago, I started my YouTube channel. And back then, there were only like cat videos and prank videos. And there wasn't really any crafted skits or anything where people were coming up with characters and kind of doing a skit and editing it and putting it online, right? So I said, I would make longer videos for the family anyway. So I thought, what if I created this channel? And I wanted to come up with an interesting name, a memorable name. And I thought, Christine Gambito ain't gonna, I mean, that's not gonna be memorable. You know, it's hard to say even, Christine Gambito, very harsh, you know. Had people tell me, yeah, your name is really harsh, like Christine Gambito. Yeah, it doesn't flow very well. So I was like, what am I gonna name this thing? I don't know. And then finally I thought, what if I take a funny memory from the past? So my mom would always tell me and my sister to wear your, I don't know, you guys may not have had this from your mom, but my mom was just always like, if you're going to wear a dress, make sure to wear your happy slip. Okay, so she meant half slip. But the way she would say half slip, so there's a full slip or a half slip. And my mom would pronounce it happy slip, okay? Your happy slip. You're not wearing your happy slip. Make sure to wear your happy slip, right? So that was just normal for me. But in my brain, it was spelled happy slip. So it's like, I mean, that's normal, right? So I go to school one day and I'm like, oh, I forgot to wear my happy slip. And one of my friends and classmates, they were like, what, you got a sad slip too? And I thought, I literally was confused. What do you mean? It's a happy slip. So I thought it was a funny memory to kind of recall, but also a dual purpose to the name, because I want people to slip into happiness when they watch the videos. And so that's why I picked the name Happy Slip. I wanted it to be Happy Slip Productions, but that's too long. So I shortened it to Happy Slip, not knowing people would think that's my name or they call me by that. Oh, Happy Slip. Oh. So now forever I'm happy. That's my name, Happy Slip, I guess. You know, who would know? But anyway, that's a little background on the name. As far as me getting into comedy or any of that, I didn't even realize what I was doing was stand-up comedy for my family. So some of you might have grown up, you know, potlucks and parties, and then the family's bored after they eat. Okay, come on, kids. Where's the entertainment? Come on. Come on. You sing karaoke. You play piano. Come on, do your dancing. Recite your poem. Come on. And then with me, literally, my mom would come up to me, come on, Christine. Everybody is bored. Come on, can you imitate me? Okay, please, will you imitate me? They're bored. And I'm like, what? So literally, I was doing imitation on demand. I would be in front of the family, okay, do Auntie so-and-so. And then do Uncle so-and-so, do your sister, do your mom, do your dad. And I'm sitting here doing all these characters. Finally, I got sick of kind of doing this over and over every party. So I started making videos. I was like, here, just play it. Just watch it. There you go. 30 minutes long. Then YouTube came along and I thought, hey, what if I make it shorter? So that is the history behind Happyslip. Now, them saying, here's my title here, The Failing Road to True Success. Now, for Romeo to say 100 million views, maybe some people would think that's true success. But do you think that's true success for me, right? To some people, some YouTubers who started out that kind of OG era, I still keep in touch with a lot of those OG YouTubers who have gone on to get more than a million subscribers, billions, you know, who knows, billions of views and all that. So me and my little 100 million, maybe I'm a failure to them, right? So I want to talk about this failing road. Or like I'm saying, some people will think in your life as you're on this journey, you are a failure, but actually you're on a true road of success. So I want to kind of discuss what that is to me. What is true success? So let me just back up a little bit, give you an overview, kind of like a bird's eye view, that I feel like my life is like a jigsaw puzzle. So if maybe sometimes you guys can relate to that, where it's like, imagine a 2,000 piece jigsaw puzzle. And you're like, oh, this is life. Oh, how can I start putting this together? It's confusing. How do I do this? You start to learn how to organize the pieces. If you guys have even taken it, you're like, what's a jigsaw puzzle? Maybe you haven't even you know, wanted to mess with putting one together. But if you've had to face a big one, like 1,000 or 2,000, it's kind of like, what? Where do I start? There's so many, right? But as life goes on, you start to learn how to put the pieces together, organize the colors, right? And you start to group them. Well, I feel like life is like that, because sometimes you try to put pieces together and you're like, oh no, that doesn't fit. Or it fools you, right? Because you think, this should fit here. It looks like it should fit here. This color looks like this should go with this, and it should go here. Sometimes you'll take a whole section and try to put it somewhere. You're like, you will go here. You will go here, right? Well, to me, I feel like my life being a jigsaw puzzle, I feel like I don't even know what the box looks like, right? I don't know what the picture is exactly, but I know that God knows, right? And he orchestrated, and he knew the picture before it was even into pieces. So for me, going through life is just following his lead of where to put the pieces together. So let's talk about my failures, right? You all have probably had the pressure of your parents kind of saying, oh, you know, when you get older, you're going to be a nurse or a doctor, you know, these kind of assumptions, right? So they think they know what the picture of the jigsaw puzzle should look like. They're like, I know exactly, you will be dentist. You will be, right? All these things. And of course, a nurse, every Filipina is going to be a nurse, right? My dad, though, he would have weird ideas. Oh, I want you to join the FBI. One day it's the FBI, the next day it's orthodontist. You know, those orthodontists make so much money. I thought you want me to join the FBI, Dad. Like, okay. So never in their minds would they encourage me to be a comedian, though, right? So here they are, encouraging nursing, and I caved, and I went into nursing, and I went as far as LPN, because in my mind, I wanted to always do acting, right? I didn't know how that was gonna take form, but I wanted to satisfy the family, get them off my backs, get them off my back, and then, just go ahead and do nursing, but not all the way. I'm just going to do up to LPN to have a good practical skill, LPN, right? But you have that auntie, LPN, what is that? Low-paid nurse? Because, you know, your cousin Lisa, she's an RN, rich nurse. Don't you know? Your cousin Lisa has a master's. How about you? You're just LPN. You know, so this pressure of like, oh gosh. I found myself enrolled in an LPN to BSN program. And I attended, I think, for about a month, and that was it. Because I was like, what am I doing? Maybe it was like 2 weeks. It's like, what am I doing here? Taking classes that I didn't even want to take, right? So I said to myself, I'm doing this for everybody else but me. So in my family's mind, my community, Filipino community especially, I'm a failure, right? Look at this road to failing. Failure right there, right? Because I didn't pursue, I think, what they wanted me to. Now, my mom knew I was funny and she would ask me to imitate, but again, she wasn't gonna have me pursue that kind of career. So I didn't know what I was gonna do. Now here goes the puzzle pieces again, where I was a failure yet again, because if they had the picture of the puzzle ready to deliver to me, it would be like, you're going to finish school, go to college, get your master's, get your doctorate, date when you're 40, then get married, then give us grandkids, right? But I failed them again, because guess what? I got married when I was very young. I'm not encouraging you all that every young person needs to go get married like I did. But 23 years later, we've been married 23 years, and don't try to do the math because you're gonna figure that I got married when I was 6 years old. That's right. I failed them. But again, it wasn't like so easy to make that decision, but I had to follow where I felt the pieces were being sovereignly put together. And a lot of times I feel in our lives, it's not gonna be what people expect or want of you, but the way that it's sovereignly executed is gonna be different, okay? So moving on, after being married for so many years, so I was pursuing acting in New York City. My husband supported me to do that. Lived with my sister in an apartment in New York City. He would visit me every other weekend because he was stationed in the Navy, and he would sacrifice to visit me every other weekend. And I would fly, you know, back and forth trying to. This was pre-9/11 now, so it was cheap to fly back then. But anyway, so I'm pursuing acting. I'm SAG after I'm union. I'm a working actress. I have a reputable agent, but I'm getting kind of these roles that don't really make me feel like I can really show my talent, right? I mean, these roles are mostly industrials, training films, how to put on gloves, how to put on goggles, how to operate a forklift. I don't even know what, but they were like these just skills, and I was, okay, so kind of boring, but I was getting paid, right? Well, after 2 years, I felt, yeah, okay, so I did the acting thing. Not real thrilled about the roles, right? But something was telling me your time in New York is done. Well, I feel that was God's direction. But anyway, my husband got stationed again in Virginia, and I thought, that's it. I got to give up on my dream. That's it. I'm a failure again. Failure, right? But what happened, I started having dreams about buildings crashing and glass breaking and fires exploding and this kind of thing. And my agent at the time sat me down. She goes, you're not leaving New York City. You're a working actress. You know how many people want that? There's this many people that move to the city that want to act. And you're in this working segment, a working actress. You don't leave New York City. I said, my husband. She said, husband, schmusband. You stay in New York City. She had a picture of the jigsaw puzzle, which she thought she was going to plan out for me. Well, guess what? I don't know what those dreams were about at that time, but then my husband, I had a dream also about being on the top of the Empire State Building, and there was this huge black hole that I was afraid I was gonna fall in, and I'm literally climbing on the sides, and my husband is carrying me out with a very concerned look on his face, and so that was another dream of mine. Well, literally, he packs up my stuff, brings me out of New York City, moves me out. 3 weeks later, 9/11 happened, and I was supposed to work as a nurse 3 blocks away from the World Trade Center. So, again, I just had to follow where I felt the pieces of the puzzle were sovereignly moving. I couldn't just trust in someone else's plan for me or what they thought the picture should be. I was supposed to work as a nurse, like I said, 3 blocks away, and I knew, I turned on my TV that day, I saw the second plane hit, and I said I would have run towards the disaster area, because in a nursing uniform, I wouldn't have run the other way. So I think the dreams were just kind of warning me. But anyway, yet again, you could say, the world would say, you failed at mainstream acting. You failed at your career, right? Thank God I failed. Thank God I walked away when I did. If I had tried to make my career work the way that agent told me to, Happyslip would have never happened. So it opened the door, this failure opened the door for us to then move back to New York a few years later, just because I had gotten so close to friends and community and our church family there. We moved back and I started Happyslip from our apartment right there in New York City. And I didn't realize what kind of platform that would have for me. So, and then with YouTube, you all know what it's turned into today. It's easy to be lost in that kind of shuffle, right? Anyone would probably look at me and say, oh, she dropped off the map. She's a failure yet again, right? But I'm not contributing so much on YouTube, more on Facebook, just because I feel like Filipinos easily share on Facebook. They're just, why is that funny? It's true. They seem to share more on Facebook, right? So anyway, what I'm trying to say is true success for me has never been what people plan for my life. Has never been. True success to me is the entire puzzle, the entire picture. And for me, that meant building a family, right? Not just the career. If you guys think of your own lives and you say, it's all about the career, I've got to make my name known, I've got to build here, and you only build one part of your puzzle, I feel like, well, you're not going to feel whole and complete anyway. So for me, I built over here, and the video career was good and nice, but to me, something good, I didn't want to turn it into something ultimate for me. Although it's good, I didn't want to make it ultimate, the ultimate thing. So then with my family, I built there, and I want to feel like I'm building a legacy. I'm building into eternity. I'm not building for a little bit of fame, a little bit of fortune, a little bit of laughs. No, I want to make an impact. I want to help, serve, and love people. And building first into my family was very important to me, so I felt that's building into eternity. That's true success for me. The world may never know. They'll think, oh, she dropped off, she's a failure, you know, stuff like that. But like I said, true success for me is the big puzzle picture, complete, whole, and creating a lasting legacy. So I wish that for all of you guys. Thank you for having me. And enjoy the rest of your night. So thank you. Yeah.